Welcome to Analog Communication Playlist. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you FM generation by indirect method of Armstrong in this session. So here we will be generating FM signal by indirect method of Armstrong. So here first I'll explain a basic block diagram which is there with FM generation by indirect method of Armstrong. Now see, in this method, first our agenda is to generate narrowband FM signal. So let me show you this by a basic overview, then after we will see that with detailed understanding. So here we have a block which is generating narrowband FM signal. So this block that generates narrowband FM signal, right? Now after this block will be having frequency multiplier. After this block will be having frequency multiplier. After that we have frequency conversion. After that again we have frequency multiplier. And frequency conversion that is been done with respect to crystal oscillator frequency. And here we have FM signal. Now see, this is the basic overview which is there with this indirect method of Armstrong. Now I'll explain, like see how all those things is happening step by step. So first of all, when we want to generate narrowband FM signal, if I say I have modulating signal, let us say I have modulating signal that is empty, which is over here, right? Then I have already explained narrowband FM generation, where here we are passing it through integrator, right? And after that we have a product modulator. So over here we have product modulator, and see, product modulator that is having input, and see here we have crystal oscillator, and this crystal oscillator generates EC cos omega CT signal, and that is what we pass it through phase shifter of pi by 2. So here we have a phase shifter of pi by 2, and then here by adder we add crystal oscillator and output of this product modulator, and this is what my narrowband FM output, and then I'm giving it to frequency multiplier. Now our agenda is to understand entire thing in proper detailed understanding, right? So here I'll explain everything step by step. So see, here we have message signal empty, and after passing it through integrator, over here my signal will be integration of m of t, and here crystal oscillator that generates signal EC cos of omega CT, right? So over here even our signal will be EC cos of omega CT. And as if this EC cos of omega CT that is passing through phase shifter of pi by 2, this will be minus EC sine of omega CT, right? And in product modulator, output will be multiplication of two inputs. So this signal will be minus EC sine omega CT into integration of MT, right? And this adder will add both of this signal. So resultant narrowband frequency modulated signal that will be EC cos of omega CT, that is this, plus this signal that is minus EC sine omega CT into integration of MT, right? So this is my narrowband frequency modulated signal. And that is what I have already explained it in my previous session. Now see, this signal that we will be giving it to frequency multiplier, and then frequency conversion, and again frequency multiplier. So first of all, let us try to understand this by one example, so it will gives you a bit clear idea, like see how we are doing this, why we are doing this. So here, if I say my narrowband FM signal that is having carrier signal, let us say FC1, and that is 200 kilohertz. And if I say deviation in frequency, let us say delta F1, that is 50 hertz, right? Sorry, 25 hertz. Let us say it is 25 hertz. And FM signal output, that should be, let us say FC4, and that is 91.2 megahertz. And deviation in frequency, let us say delta F4, that is 76.8 kilohertz. See, this is what one case, which is what we are considering, right? Now there can be a question like, why do we do this frequency multiplication twice, and in between that there is a need of frequency conversion. So let us try to understand this by practical calculation, where if we do frequency multiplication once, in that case what will happen? So here, see, if you observe this deviation in frequency, right? So if I consider round figure 75 kilohertz, then how many times I need to do multiplication? So 75 kilohertz means 75000 divided by 25. So 3000, that should be multiplication factor, right? So here, if I do multiplication by 3000, then what will happen with carrier signal frequency? So deviation will get to this figure, right? But in that case, what will be carrier signal frequency? So here 200 kilohertz carrier signal frequency is there. And with that, if I multiply 3000, then my carrier frequency at output side, that will be 600 megahertz. And what we want? 91.2 megahertz. So as we wanted to have 91.2 megahertz of frequency, right, we cannot multiply this signal with 3000 frequency multiplier. If you do this, in that case deviation will be this, but carrier frequency will be 600 megahertz. And what we want? 91.2 megahertz. So all we will be doing is, we will be doing this multiplication operation two times, right? And here this 3000, that we are bisecting into two different fraction. One is 64 and one is 48. So here we will be multiplying frequency multiplier by 64 over here, and over here we'll be doing this by 48, right? And this is what we are doing it as per nth law of operation of frequency multiplication. So as per nth law, we have decided this multiplier should be having multiplication of 64 and this should be having 48, right? Now see what will happen. If you do this multiplier by 64, here our output, that will be having FC2, and that will be multiplied with 64. So 200 kilohertz into 64, that will be, we can say 12.8 megahertz, right? And see, this delta F1 is getting multiplied with 64. So 25 into 64, so that is 1600, means we can say 1.6 kilohertz. So we can say delta F2, that is 1.6 kilohertz, right? Now here we will be doing frequency conversion operation. So after having a frequency conversion, we'll be having a new signal over here, and that new signal will be having a deviation, that is 1.6 kilohertz only, but carrier signal will get changed. And see, this frequency conversion, that we can have it based on this crystal oscillator. So we can tune that conversion by having this crystal oscillator frequency. So what should be the signal which is over here? Now see, deviation will not change over here in frequency conversion. So deviation, if I say this is f delta f3, so that is 1.6 kilohertz only, and over here my fc3, now that will be as per crystal oscillator frequency, right? And what should be this my output as per this frequency conversion? So that will be based on this frequency multiplier. So here 91.2, that signal is there, right? So if I do frequency conversion as per 91.2 divided by 48, so that is 1.9 megahertz. So here fc3, that will be 1.9 megahertz, right? So here in frequency conversion there will be two components, right? If I say this crystal oscillator frequency is f dash, right? So here there will be two components, fc2 plus f dash and fc2 minus f dash, and here we'll be taking this difference and summation that will exceed this frequency. Here see, input frequency is 12.8 megahertz, we wanted to have 1.9 megahertz. So we will be taking difference, and as per difference, this crystal oscillator frequency f dash, that should be, resultant should be 1.9, right? So 12.8 minus 1.9, that is 10.9. So f dash, that has to be 10.9 megahertz. And based on that, we can generate this signal that is having 1.9 hertz of carrier signal frequency. And then again, frequency multiplication is been done. So here, as per this FM generation by indirect method, there are few things that we need to take care of. First, we will be having narrowband FM generation. And after that, we will be having frequency multiplication twice. And in between that, we will be having frequency conversion once, where frequency conversion is being done based on crystal oscillator frequency. And here one more thing that we should understand. See, here we are using frequency multiplier. So how to do frequency multiplication operation? So let us try to understand this. See, this is what we are doing it by having. First, we will be having non-linear device. And after that, we will pass it through band pass filter, right? And the resultant will be frequency multiplier. So see, this is what the basic block diagram, which is there with frequency multiplier. Now, how we are achieving this? Let us try to understand this. So let us say we have XT input, and this XT is equals to cos theta, right? And if I say my output of non-linear device, that is, let us say y dash of t, right? And after passing it through band pass filter, let us say my output is y of t. And how to have frequency multiplication? Let us try to understand this. So what is my non-linear device output? So non-linear device output, that is purely based on input signal. So non-linear device output, if I say it is y dash of t, then that has to be a0 plus a1 into xt, where xt is input signal, plus a2 into x square t, plus a3 into x cube of t, plus up to a4 into x raised to 4 of t. See, that is how my output of non-linear device will be there. Now see here, xt, that is cos theta, right? So let me mention it, a0 plus a1 cos theta plus a2 cos square theta plus a3 cos cube theta plus a4 cos raised to 4 theta. See, that is how components will be there. Now let us try to understand what is re-elaboration of this. So here if you see cos square theta, then cos square theta, that is half of 1 plus cos 2 theta. If you see real aberration of cos cube theta, then that is 1 by 4 of cos theta plus cos 3 theta. So if you further re-elaborate this, you'll be finding there are components which is there in terms of cos 2 theta, cos 3 theta, cos 4 theta, cos 5 theta. That is how components will be there, right? So I can simplify this equation where I don't know what is that multiplication coefficient. So instead of A0, A1, A2, now I'll write that by B0, B1, B2. So I can say this y dash t, that could be now B0 plus B1 into cos theta plus B2 into cos 2 theta plus B3 into cos 3 theta plus B4 into cos 4 theta. See, that is how my output will be there, right? Now, when I pass this signal through bandpass filter, at that time we have bandpass filter which will be having frequency which is what we are allowing only, right? So if I say instead of this theta, here if this theta is equals to fc, right? Here if I say this theta cos of omega c t, right? Then this equation that will be having different frequency components. Now if this bandpass filter that is only allowing 6 omega c frequency, right? Then it will allow only 6 omega c frequency. So you will be finding output of this bandpass filter, that will be B6 cos of 6 omega c t, right? So you will be finding, like, see, this is how frequency multiplier is there. First there will be nonlinear device and then we pass it through bandpass filter and that will be resulting into frequency multiplier. So here I have shown you example of 6 omega c. So here I am multiplying frequency with 6, but likewise we can generate any multiplier, right? And see here, this multiplication 64 into 48, that is around 3000, right? So that is what we have chosen based on nth law of frequency multiplication. And this is how we generate FM signal by using indirect method of Armstrong. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will solve your queries. Thank you so much for watching.